Okay, so I'm having a look at the Ibanez Butterbean. Thanks for the info. Somebody spouted off a model number, which I'll regurgitate later. We're looking at what we hate about it. We hate that it's filthy. Oh, on the back, complaints about all this shredding and marking on the back of the neck. I'll attempt to wet sand that out of there. I might break through the lacquer, but the lacquer's already been broke. Back's in nice shape. Not sure what happened there. It looks like it just got chewed on. So we'll clean it up. String action is a little higher than we'd like to see. The neck. Well, it's got a little more. Well, actually, it's probably got about the right amount of curve. Just got to get the string action down to where it belongs. You can see that my hoard is becoming less and less of a hoard. We're getting her down. This ain't going to be the workbench, folks. This is just a temporary solution to my current problem. And oh, the best is I figured out why I love G&L. Come on. Who else has got a guitar sticker like that? I said before I moved, I was going to throw this cable in the garbage, and that's what I'm doing right now. Ta-da! Ta-da! It's in the freaking garbage! Okay. Scratchy. Nothing to worry about. Oh, maybe yes, maybe yes. We'll want to clean all that crap out of there. I don't know. Let's get busy, fix it up. Please, please help me, Ibanez. Help me, help me. Yeah, this fancy microphone. See, now it's pointed at me so I can talk. Before it was pointed at the amp so it would make noise. Okay, back to getting it better. So I took the strings off. The truss rod is doing nothing. It's not even engaged. It's just floating loose there. There, that now we just got some tension on it. So I'll straighten the neck now with the strings off it. Once again, you see, I need a shaved down metric. Metric, metric. Okay, hold on. So this neck is almost want the back bow. That's why the truss rod was not engaged at all. So with that in mind, let's get strings back on it quick, fast. We're going to clean up the frets, oil the fretboard, clean all the shit off this. There was some dents that he was complaining about, but I looked at it. It looks like somebody hit it with a chain. There's just so many marks in it. And they've been repaired with magic marker. Can't help you there, buddy. Oh, and it's got these things. These like Death Star strap buttons. Who invented this? What sadist came up with that? Let's get it cleaned up. So I could be using steel wool right now, but instead I'm using some 1000 grit sandpaper. And oh, what a joy. They're going to be great. You watch. Standard stuff, some Never Dull on the frets, and some linseed oil on the fretboard. Activity upstairs. Okay, we need to poke a hole in this. It's not coming out. Still ain't gonna come out. I'm in deep shit, hold on. I got her to work. It's about 10 or 15 drops tops. Rub it in. And rub it off. Man, that's a nice fretboard under there. Hope you guys can all see that. And gals too. I know there's like 4.8% girls out there. Well, that's it. So, we want to get strings on this. Only because, like I said, she wants to do it. She's almost a back bow. Almost, but not quite. Got the old radius gauges out. This is a real tight one. 7.25. And I can tell by looking at the bridge, it's just set up wrong. So, that's it. Let's find the new strings and get them on. No, actually, let's get a beer and then find the new strings and get them on. I guess I should clean this up. Get some air in there. If you don't have a compressor, you can use the canned air. This thing's light as a feather, though, too. That's pretty cool. I like that. Okay, so the neck is straight and there's actually some tension on the truss rod, so that's good. I think what happened before was they set the string action too high because they didn't know how to set the relief properly. So let's get the string action right and then we can loosen the truss rod a little bit and this thing's gonna play like a rocket. I can already tell. It's just looking great. Holy smokes, what's going on? Can't get the microphone to do. There we go. Ah, we gotta look at that. See, often that's just lack of use. See how it all went away after I did that? So, what was wrong? The radius was all out. The arc of the strings was all out. Didn't take much to tweak it back in. Somebody had jacked up the A and or the G and E, and they thought that the strings should all be the same height. it some sort of collector's thing. It's a Ibanez Butterbean bass guitar. Still got to sort out this thing on the back of the neck. And I don't know, maybe a little more cleanup. Still looking like she's got some DNA on it. And like I said, where they took a chain to it, I can't help. Seems to have a lot of high end though. Well, that could be because there's no bass on the amp. And I'm using this little poopy amp too. There, I'm Bootsy Collins.